drafted to secure the necessary savings. Over the page, we just confirm that after undertaking our initial risk assessment, using our knowledge gained from previous years, using the help of internal audit and the various mechanisms that have been referenced in the Liable Government Statement, we identified one significant risk that we want them to take further work on for 2015-16, and that's our review of the arrangements that you have in place to both identify, quantify, and then deliver the challenging savings plans that you need to implement. We've commenced this work already. We understand that the capital have undertaken work alongside the council, and between us now and reaching our conclusions in August, we'll undertake further work to look at the governance arrangements, how it's reported, how it's monitored and identified, and hopefully keeps on track to deliver the significant amounts, both in 15-16 and 129 million by 2021. And we'll report those findings back to the council in our audit findings report later in the year. Just finally, the key dates are shown on 173, and as I mentioned, I need to reference to you, 174 sets out the audit fee. Confirm that's actually set independently of grant order by PSAA and reflects a reduction in the fee that was charged to the council in 2014-15. We confirm that we have no independence issues that we need to bring to your attention. And finally, sure all the matters that we need to bring to your attention that we cover in the audit plan and the further ones to be included in the audit final report that we bring back to the September meeting. So that's the audit plan. Happy to take any questions if you have some.
Questions? So in summary then, Grant Thornton is an external auditor, has identified no weaknesses, particularly within the authority, and the only significant risk is that imposed upon it by central government because of the 5 years of cuts that we've had to sustain.
Our work for 15-16, the interim work to date, hasn't identified any weaknesses. The bulk of our work is yet to start, as I mentioned, we're undertaking an initial risk assessment of value for money. The bar for significant risk is set quite high.
Yeah.
You'd be looking at significant savings to be achieved if you were to undertake any additional PFI schemes, or there was a large transformational change planned, both any way you deliver services or about not to deliver services. Just the level of significance is set quite high. But at the moment, we're not seeing individual risks local to the authority that are not different to the national position.
Yeah.
Phil, I think you're asking.
Oh, yeah. Maybe Mr. Salt can help us all along with Grant Thornton. When the medium-term financial strategy was presented to Cabinet in February, it was an action plan, and the action plan required various things to be done, and so there was a review. One of the things in the action plan, according to what we're supposed to be doing in June, is Cabinet agrees priority areas for the development of savings and business cases. So if we were following that action plan, is that work on target?
I think it's fair to say that work is being undertaken, whether it's at the stage. I would personally like to be able to use it with you. I think we're probably a bit behind where we need to be, but that possibly reflects the complexity of the issues we're trying to deal with. The key thing that came out perhaps since is the government considering about the 4 year settlement on it and the need to produce some form of evidence to justify why, as a council, you feel you go forward and accept that offer. Where there's guidance due to come out sometime during June, July, both CIFRA and the various other bodies, to say this is the sort of information or the sort of way you present that data. So, in a way, we're working towards what we feel we need to do for our medium-term financial strategy. But whether that will meet the requirements the government are going to ask for in terms of going before you offer, we don't know until our guidance comes out. So, it's a bit of a chicken and egg. I think what we should produce in our medium-term strategy should fit the bill. But in terms of the detail beyond this, we're not clear yet what detail the government are going to ask for in terms of, if you take a 4 year offer, how do you balance the books over 4 years? What level of detail are they looking for? Is it a broad picture as to how you deliver it? Or do you ask for the specifics?
one we can savour and think about.
Signposts that we are about to complete our final accounts on the year-end audit, and we hope to complete by the end of August in preparation for the mandated early close down that all authorities will have to adhere to in the future years. And then the pages that follow are a series of articles of interest, hopefully. They contain synopsis of various Grant Thornton reports or other national reports on other entities, and also electronically, which should be sufficiently interested to find out more information. Again, these are just for information, and hopefully members will find them of some help. If there were any areas that you want further information on, then we would be pleased to bring further guidance or responses to future committees.
Ron?
Evidence obtained by covert surveillance. A member of the public
was sentenced to 3 months imprisonment, suspended for 12 months. 12 months in community order, in order to pay costs of £1,200 to cover cleanup and prosecution costs for high tipping